Well, aloha and greetings from Hawaii. I got into Honolulu yesterday at around 11 o'clock a.m. and I spent the first afternoon just settling, which was yesterday, settling into the hotel and getting myself acquainted. And this morning I went for a tour around the main island of which Honolulu is, you know, situated, and it was a rather long trip. It was about 9 hours. It was quite challenging. What I found difficult was that it was just sort of difficult to sort of get, I guess, you know, certain foods like and water, or, you know, like getting water and things like that. But apart from that, I went out to the USS Arizona Memorial, which is at Pearl Harbor. And as I went out to this was part of the tour that I was on, I just thought about the actual lives that were lost on that ship. And there were over 900 young men that were killed on that ship in Pearl Harbor on December the 7th, 1941. To me, that was really moving, and I was almost close to tears, actually, when I was watching the video. Because I thought to myself, you know, that I know so many young people, I know so many young men myself, and I have some people I know that are in their 20s, and I just thought to myself, you know, they were so young, these men. And they all went to the grave at such an early age. And I had my little Bible with me that I took with me, and I just opened it to Matthew 9:38, which therefore, when Jesus said, "Therefore pray earnestly to the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." And I just, that passage was opened, and I read it, and I had a chat to one of the Marines that was on the side itself, and you know, just was very moving that beneath my feet, beneath all these people and on this board that was on at the memorial, there was all these souls that were deceased, they were killed, they were young men. They didn't even know that they were being hit, and they were all killed, 900 of them. And I just thought to myself, I spoke to the lady there about, she wanted to live in Brisbane actually, but she was telling me a bit about their story, and I had the Bible with me, and I just said I wanted to remember these young lives that were lost. And I just thought to myself, with the younger generations today, how much do they really value and respect these lives lost, these young men that were the same age as them that were killed in such a horrible situation. I also met a young married man who was a Mormon, and he was, maybe God brought him to me to be with me. I always sort of want to make friends all the time, you know, like I want to have all these guy friends that, and but it's not about being popular, it's just about, you know, what I find is that friendships are hard work and relationships are even hard work. And the thing is that I sort of want friends, and then I find that just mentally I can't keep up with communicating. There's just something that just doesn't seem to allow things to happen easily, like friendships and relationships. And I saw a lot of the people traveling around that were in relationships or whatever. And I thought, well, I don't really worry anymore because I just don't think I'd have the energy to cope with one. But today it's just sort of an unwinding period. I'm just in the hotel room. I fly out tomorrow to San Francisco, then I have a 7-hour bus ride from there the following morning out to Yosemite National Park. I think it's a train and a bus. And I have 4 nights in Yosemite National Park. Looking forward to going there. I find that when I'm actually settled somewhere, like tonight, this is my means of unwinding. I just can't be around people. I just need to have time out. I suppose it's all the organisation that I need to do when I'm travelling. But even on this bus tour today, I thought it was just a bit too long, and I just wanted to get away from the people. I just wanted to have time to myself, so I didn't really sort of, I was looking forward to, although I saw quite a lot, I was looking forward to having a rest, and I felt a bit anxious towards the end because I didn't think the bus driver was going to drop me off where my hotel is. And I also thought on one occasion I would be lost if I had to ask the bus driver to just if I could come back to the bus with him, because I just felt overwhelmed and like as if I was going to get lost. So I did that. But anyway, that's just a brief update from me for tonight. Thanks very much for watching.